What's up, everybody? Guys, I am just so excited. What's up, everybody? Dante Crisis here with Mass Effect 2. Honestly, one of my favorite games of all time, and we're just gonna go straight into it. While we wait for all of this, because this does take a while, fuck knows why, it's connecting to the servers network, the online stuff, so yeah, that's all I'll say. Oh wow, it didn't take that long. I'm going straight to this now, so early. And here we are, Sasha Shepard, who we played as last time. The reason I'm going to this so soon is because I got told by my local game when I pre-ordered Mass Effect Andromeda that it was coming out in March. So I want to get the games done before that. And fuck no, I'm not playing this on Insanity. I've done that once. Never again. Hold up. Do I want to play this on... I played the last one on Veteran, I'm sure. I don't think there was a Hardcore. Fuck it, let's play it on Hardcore. Name, Sasha Shepard, rank 60. Yes, for anybody who is wondering, on my last save, I was around 58, 50-something. I can't remember what my thingy was. I actually went back, did some extra stuff, like I redid a lot of stuff just so I could get to rank 60. So that's why I'm using this one, because I did that in my free time. I really wanted to start off with rank 60. It is legitimately earned, so I feel no need. Paragon, we saved her, not Rex. Caden died on Vermeer, and we saved the council. So hot, I'm so excited. This is legitimately one of my favorite games of all time, and to be playing again, I'm very happy.
Shepard did everything right, more than we could have hoped for. Saving the Citadel, even saving the Council, humanity has the trust of the entire galaxy. And still, it's not enough.
It's never
our
enough.
Sacrifices have earned the Council's gratitude, but Shepard remains our best hope.
But they're sending her to fight Geth. Geth? We both know they're not the real threat. The Reapers are still out there.
And it's up to us to stop them.
The Council will never trust Cerberus. They'll never accept our help, even after everything humanity has accomplished. But Shepard, they'll follow her. She's a hero, a bloody icon.
Damn right.
But she's just one woman. If we lose Shepard, humanity might well follow.
This big smile.
Then see to it that we don't lose her.
Okay, Mr. Creepy Eyes. Alright, so there's our little backstory to what led us to this moment. Ah, there she is, the beautiful Normandy. Honestly, that's the one thing I can say about Mass Effect 2 and 3. These games still look great for me.
Board is green, we are running silent.
We're wasting our time. 4 days searching up and down this sector, and we haven't found any sign of Geth activity.
Then again, this is pre-rendered, so...
3 ships went missing here in the past month. Something happened to them.
My money's on slavers. The Terminus system is crawling with them.
Picking up something on the long-range scanner. Unidentified vessel. Looks like a cruiser.
Doesn't match any known signatures.
Yeah, I wonder why.
Cruiser is changing course. Now on intercept trajectory.
Can't be. Stealth systems are engaged. There's no way a Geth ship could possibly...
It's not the Geth. Brace for evasive maneuvers!
I got nothing to say during this. I'm just enjoying.
Presley!
Kinetic barriers down. Multiple hull breaches. Weapons offline. Somebody get that fire out.
This is something, though, I will say. You can obviously see that the beam is tracking the ship. It doesn't do that later on. Can only hope.
The Alliance won't abandon us. We just need to hold on. Get everyone onto the escape shuttles. Joker's still in the cockpit. He won't evacuate. I'm not leaving either.
Yeah, you are. Because I'm telling you so.
I need you to get the crew onto the evac shuttles. I'll take care of Joker.
Ow.
Shepard, Liara, go. Now. Aye, aye.
Oh, fuck. You know what? That is the body language of someone who is like, oh, fucking hell again.
Go, go, go!
Though that's something I don't understand. Though, I actually find this game more graphic than Mass Effect 2, the Mass Effect 1, yet this ends up being a 15 rating while Mass Effect 1 is an 18 rated game here in the UK. I don't get that. Like, this game quite literally liquidates people. So, how? I don't know. Alright, before we start anything else, I don't know if it's me. Okay, so it is just me. I was wondering, it really seemed blurry. It might just be me or the screen, but things kind of seemed a little blurry then. Yeah, we're doing fucked. Ah, fucking hell, I love this game. I'm just going to be gushing all over this game, everybody, and I make no apologies for it. I think this is a masterpiece of a game. I really do. And though there are some things that I believe Mass Effect 3 did improve on, like I believe the combat was ironed out perfectly for Mass Effect 3. It has too many drawbacks to overtake this. Man, you got a hard on for this ship.
The Normandy's lost. Going down with the ship won't change that.
Yeah, okay. Help me up.
And there's something actually I never mentioned in Mass Effect 1, I believe. I think Seth Green really grew into the role. Hook, line, and sinker throughout the entire series. And there's just a few things out. And I think everybody else improved. The one thing I will say, though, is I think the actor who plays Male Shepard, can't fucking remember his name, I apologize. I think he improved the greatest among all of them. By Mass Effect 3, he was really believable. This has got to be terrifying. And that's a suit rupture. And this, ladies and this, boys and girls, is how Commander Sasha Shepard died. Oh, the Jesus metaphors have started already. Show it to me. Show it to me. There it is. There it is. If you don't know about, if you haven't realized by now, I love this game. Fucking $10 million man going on right here. We can rebuild her. We have the technology. We can make her better, stronger, faster.
Commander Shepard has been recovered.
Pieces of her. Truly, stem cell research has come a very long way. Though they do explain it in the Citadel DLC on Mass Effect 3 how this was all done. Oh, speaking of which, speaking of DLC, this is how this is going to go, everybody. I'm going to do the main story first. Yes, except. Except imported first. Oh. I'm going to be doing the... And I was a Vanguard, wasn't I? So I'm going to stick with Vanguard. Yes. Right, okay, and I get an achievement. Okay, it gives me an achievement. So what do I want? I would like... I've always done well with warp ammo. I can get barrier? I thought barrier was in defaulting. Oh, whatever. So, as I was saying, yeah, fine. I will be doing the main game first, and then I will be doing all of the DLC afterwards, and this is how I've always played the game, because it always got me the result that I wanted. So
she's reacting to outside stimuli, showing an awareness of her surroundings. Oh my god, Miranda, I think she's waking up.
Well, no shit. Hello.
Damn it, Wilson, she's not ready yet. Give her the sedative.
Everybody's bald.
Shepard, don't try to move, just lie still, try to stay calm.
Heart rate's still climbing. Brain activity is off the charts. Stats pushing into the red zone. It's not working.
Another dose. Now.
That's to give me two doses of sedatives.
Stats falling back into normal range. Too close. We almost lost her.
I told you your estimates were off. Run the numbers again.
Hi. I'm going to resist making a bunch of I tap that comments, but damn, I tapped that.
Shepard, do you hear me? Get out of that bed now. This facility is under attack. Shepard, your scars aren't healed, but I need you to get moving. This facility is under attack.
Yeah. Okay, now what is with this? I can see those scars more clearly. Yeah. The problem is Yeah. Problem is... Oh, fuck! I got incendiary ammo as well. Fuck. I didn't realize I'd get incendiary ammo, otherwise I would have fucking chose... I would have chose barrier. And cryo ammo. Fucking hell. Alright. Whatever. Okay, right, well, I can rock these three. Because warp ammo is pretty... Honestly, I would say warp ammo is one of the most OP things in this game. It is just devastating. Press space to pick up the pistol? Oh, there we go.
This pistol doesn't have a thermal... It's a med bay. We'll get you a clip. Keep your head down, Shepard.
Oh, fucking hell. I'm gonna really... These.
Look out.
Fuck.
Keep moving. We need to get to the shuttles.
Yeah. Sorry, just Again, my problem with Spec Ops: The Line, multiple commands put to one fucking button. One moment while I change some things around. Don't want to use charge just yet. Put that there. Perfect. Haha, lethal force. No, you don't. I really do love Vanguard class, though. Boom! Fucking charge. The greatest thing in this game. Oh, and charge, honestly, is so fucking... There is one reason I chose Vanguard. Because charge gets severely fucking overpowered in Mass Effect 3. Damn. Okay. Poor guy. Poor people. Oh, do they? Bye. God, I love this. Oh, and unlike the other games, I will be using the DLC stuff for the simple reason it really doesn't add. Then get the fuck out of there. It doesn't really add that much aid to the game, really. Ow. Progress is slow, but shows signs of recovery. Major organs are again functional, and there are signs of rudimentary neurological activity. Oh, that's good. To accelerate the process, we've moved from simple organic reconstruction of the subject to biosynthetic fusion. Initial results show promise. And also, the thing is, with this class, I think I start off with SMGs, but I don't get a good SMG until the Kasumi DLC, which I will be doing after the main game, so I'm kind of fucked. Until I get to the collector's ship. The cost of this project is astronomical. Over 4 billion credits so far. Jesus. But nobody seems to care that we've gone over budget. I don't know where the boss gets all his money. Maybe it's better not to know. He'd be peddling his own ass to get it. A little more in my direction once in a while. He'd be peddling his own ass just to get that fucking dosh. You got a severe fucking hard on for Commander Shepard. Here we go. And this is where hacking becomes a lot more simplified, but honestly, I very much prefer it. Because, holy shit. The reason I prefer this hacking over Mass Effect 1's hacking, which honestly, in the PC version, is better. It's because I went from PlayStation 1 Mass Effect 1 hacking, which is a fucking Simon Says game, and it's annoying as hell. What up? Oh, you dead, dude. You dead. I'm surprised you weren't staining that whole glass. Log update. I can't figure Miranda out. This project director, she should be ecstatic at all the progress we've made. But she's still the same old Ice Queen. Maybe she's worried Shepard might become the new favorite. Or maybe she is just a pure cold-hearted bitch. Yeah, well. She's actually rather lovely once you get to know her. What up? Hey Jacob, what's up, buddy? How you doing? How you doing, son? Oh shit!
What are you doing here? Thought you were still a work in progress.
Barely.
Are you with Miranda?
Yeah. Sorry, I forgot this is all new to you right now. I'm Jacob Taylor. I've been stationed here for.
Hostiles detected.
Damn it! Things must be worse than I thought if Miranda's got you running around. I'll fill you in, but we better get you to the shuttle first.
I know one question.
The best time, but I'm sick of stumbling around when I don't know what's going on.
Fair enough. I'll give you the quick version. You and your ship were attacked and destroyed. You were killed, dead as dead can be when they brought you here. Our scientists spent the last 2 years putting you back together. You've been comatose, or worse, that whole time. Welcome back to your life.
And where is here?
This doesn't look like an Alliance facility.
It isn't. I can't say much more than that for now. The Alliance officially declared you killed in action. The whole galaxy thinks you're dead. And if we don't get to those shuttles, they'll be right.
But what about my crew?
Were there any other survivors from the Normandy?
I'll tell you what. You help me finish off these mechs, and I'll play 20 questions with you all day. We're low on thermal clips, but I'm a biotic. Just give the order when you want me to hit them with the good stuff.
Well, I'm a biotic as well. I think that's the one thing I think I don't, that's slightly annoying, is that people don't acknowledge what you are. Now, speaking of Jacob, Mr. Taylor. There we go. I want to get Paul in the future, because Paul will actually help. Okay, now, this is the one benefit over Mass Effect 2, but Mass Effect 1, you can actually assign your companions. Oh, no, he ain't. You can put your companions' abilities into your hotkeys.
I promise I'd answer your questions. What do you want to know?
Keeping everything really smooth and quick.
You said they spent 2 years rebuilding me. How bad were my injuries?
I'm no doctor, but it was bad. When I first saw you, you were nothing but meat and tubes.
Else
they'd have put you in a coffin. But Project Lazarus was different.
Meat and tubes.
Cutting edge technology.
What do you mean, cloning? Cybernetics?
Both.
I don't know the details. You'd have to ask the scientists. But I'm pretty sure you're not a clone. They wanted to bring you back exactly as you were. You're still you. You just might have a few extra bits and pieces now.
Why does my character look pretty shit?
What can you tell me?
Compared to Mass Effect 1.
Were there other test subjects?
Look at those cheeks.
Only had one subject. The whole point was to bring you back.
Whatever. Just you.
Even that was a challenge. 2 years. All the top scientists. The best technology money could buy.
All right.
Do you know anything about this attack? Who's behind it? What they're after?
Damn if I know. I was getting ready for some shut-eye. Then bam! Bunch of explosions. Next thing I know, every damn mech in the place starts shooting. At us. I'm guessing it had to be an inside job. You'd need top security access to hack all the mechs.
The last thing I remember is the Normandy blowing up. Did anyone else make it?
You're near Shepard. Explosions follow her.
A few servicemen from the lower decks didn't get out. Navigator Presley was killed by an explosion. But everyone else, including the non-Alliance crew, the Asari, Liara, and the Quarian, they all made it out alive.
Do you know what any of them are doing now?
I don't know, Commander. It's been 2 years. They've moved on. Left the Alliance. Could be anywhere.
They were my team. If they knew I was alive, they'd come back.
Maybe you can track them down after we get off the station. If we get off the station.
Fucking pessimist.
What's your job here?
Depends on who you ask. Technically, I'm Miranda's top lieutenant. But I'm just a soldier. I served 5 years in the Alliance before this. Now I'm in charge of the station's security. Usually a lot more dull than this. Normally I don't fire my gun unless it's target practice.
Well, I'm glad. I'm guessing you're glad you put in that fucking practice.
Woman, someone named Miranda was talking to me over the radio. We lost contact just before I ran into you.
Miranda Lawson is the station's ranking officer. She led the Lazarus team. It was her job to bring you back to life, no matter what. Should have guessed she'd try to save you. She's not about to give up on you now. You said you lost
contact.
She'd
fucking hope so.
Could you tell what was happening?
There was some gunfire and an explosion right before I lost her.
She knows how to take care of herself. But I hope she's okay.
All right, now let's GTFO.
What's the way to those shuttles?
Depends where the mechs are thickest. It's probably best if
check,
you...
check. Anyone on this frequency? Anybody still alive out there? Hello?
Wilson, this is Jacob. I'm here with Commander Shepard. Just took out a wave of mechs over in D-Wing.
Shepard's alive? How the hell... Never mind. You need to get her out
skills,
of
skills, son.
Get
that's
hard. Control room.
Roger that, Wilson. Stay on this frequency.
I think I remember a Wilson checking on me one time when I woke up.
That's him. He's the chief medical tech. Answers directly to Miranda.
Everybody does.
Service tunnels are this way.
Like, everybody answers to Miranda. She is queen bitch around here. So that ain't surprising.
Hostile!
No, you don't.
The whole station is crawling with mechs. I'm doing the best I can.
You're done!
Die.
Find us another route out of here. Preferably one that doesn't...
Oh, God. They found me.
Oh, yeah.
Wilson, where are you?
Server room B. Hurry. They're out of control.
Up those stairs.
Yeah, that's one thing as well I must apologize, because I'm so familiar with this game and I will be running it at a good pace. At least in this part, it's more noticeable. I'll be running right through fucking dialogue points.
Physical reconstruction of subject is complete, but we still need to evaluate all mental and neurological functions. Our orders were clear. Make Commander Shepard who she was before the explosion. The same mind, the same morals, the same personality. If we alter her identity in any way, if she's somehow not the woman she used to be, the Lazarus Project will have failed. I refuse to let that happen.
Well, there's a bit of brain damage. A bit of brain damage. A bit of brain damage. Oh, hey, look.
Shepard, down here!
What's up, fool?
Bastards got me in the leg!
You were there the first time I regained consciousness.
Yeah, that was me.
I'd know that bald head anywhere.
We talk about this after we fix my leg.
Should be some metagel in the first aid station on the wall. Hopefully there's enough to get him up and moving again.
Can only grab fucking hope.
From the first aid station.
There you go. Oh my god, I love hotkeys.
Thanks, Shepard. Never thought you'd save my life. Guess that makes us even now.
Nope.
I thought maybe I could shut down the security mechs, but whoever did this fried the whole system. Completely irreversible.
We didn't ask what you were doing. Why do you even have security mech clearance? You were in the bio wing.
Weren't you listening? I came here to try and fix this. Besides, I was shot. How do you explain that?
You're all strangers to me. Let's get someplace safe and then we'll sort out whose fault it is.
Right. It's all y'all fault.
We need to find Miranda. We can't leave her behind.
Forget about Miranda. She was over in D wing. The mechs were all over that sector. There's no way she survived.
Bunch of mechs won't drop Miranda. She's alive.
Then where is she? Why haven't we heard from her? There are only two possible explanations. She's either dead or she's a traitor.
Oh, shut up.
Why didn't she wake me up and warn me about the attack?
Okay, maybe she's not a traitor. But that doesn't change the facts. We're here, she's not. We need to save ourselves.
You wouldn't.
The shuttle bay is only a few.
And there we go. Yep, and there we go.
That's it. Let's get out of here.
I agree.
Okay.
But first dialogue.
But this is getting tense. Shepard, if I tell you who we work for, will you trust me?
This really isn't the time, Jacob.
We won't make it if she's expecting a shot in the back.
I always do.
Off the boss. It's your ass, Jacob.
The Lazarus Project, the program that rebuilt you. It's funded and controlled by Cerberus.
And here's where we're not going with this, because we already know who Cerberus is.
I think I ran into Cerberus a few times while I was investigating Saren. Some kind of pro-human splinter group, right?
Well, that's what the Alliance wants people to believe.
Actually, it wasn't a Black Ops group.
The Alliance declared you dead. They gave up. Cerberus spent a fortune to bring you back. Look, I'd be suspicious too, but right now we have to work together. I thought you deserved to know what's what. Once we're off the station, I'll take you to the Elusive Man. He'll explain everything.
Now, here's a good question. Elusive Man.
Elusive Man. Is he in charge of all this?
Yeah. That's not his real name, of course. Nobody knows who he really is.
It was a code name the Alliance used for him. Kind of stuck.
I don't care what they did or what you say. I am not working with terrorists.
You can tell it to the boss.
Oh, I will.
After we've saved our butt.
You know, I kind of, by the end of this game, I kind of tell the Elusive Man to stick it. Mm-hmm. Yeah, so to speak. Ah, here we go. Son of a bitch. Don't be that guy. Oh, fuck me. Got it. Holy shit. There we go. Look at this lurching motherfucker. Wait, that's the same. Oh my god, that's the same animation they give for Joker in the future.
sensors activated.
No way. God damn it. I need to disable that. I didn't even know that was still active. Sorry, everybody. I'll have to block out who that was. Don't want people being added through me. Or because of me. Mm-hmm. I'm gonna send a shockwave up their asses. Right, that one. Yeah, I'll be doing this stuff, obviously, when there's multiple enemies. Just makes micromanagement a lot easier. Oh, you were useless. And again, I think your arm was missing, so... Oh, motherfucker. Jesus, I'm not having the easiest of times with these. Nope. There we go. Pain in my ass.
Test subject has been recovered, but the damage is far worse than we initially feared. In addition to the expected burns and internal injuries from the explosion, subject has suffered significant cellular breakdown due to long-term exposure to vacuum and sub-zero temperatures. Despite the extent of the physical trauma, Wilson assures me subject is salvageable. The Lazarus Project will proceed as planned.
Oh, thanks, Wilson. They would have put me in a coffin if you hadn't spoke up. Then again, I'm sure you had your own self-serving interests. Everybody always does. There we go. I'm gonna... Oh yeah, I also will be buying all of the damn fish and models, or trying to find all of those, because I'm a goddamn completionist when it comes to this game.
Come on, through here. We're almost at the...
Well, hello, Miranda. You were... Headshot. Wait, was that in the throat or the head? That's a throat.
Dead?
What the hell are you doing?
My job. Wilson betrayed us all. Even if you're sure, did he deserve that welcome? He sabotaged the security systems, killed my staff, and he would have killed us.
You sure about that, Miranda? We've known Wilson for years. What if you're wrong?
I'm never wrong. I thought you'd have learnt that by now, Jacob.
That's what I love, actually. The male one says it like jokingly. This one was just serious to say it.
You should have taken him alive, see what he knew. Too risky. I've put too much time and effort bringing you back to life to let you get killed now.
Yeah.
You really think Wilson's capable of that?
Not anymore.
If you say so, what's our next step?
We get on the shuttle and go.
Yeah, I agree.
Wants to speak to you.
You mean the elusive man? I know you work for Cerberus.
Ah, Jacob. I should have known your conscience would get the better of you.
Lying to the commander isn't the way to get her to join our cause.
Well, since we're getting everything out in the open, is there anything else you want to ask before we go, Commander?
Yeah,
convenient
a lot.
You show up as we're leaving. Where were you during the attack?
Besides trying to save your life? Wilson figured out I was helping you and he sent an army of mechs to take me out. I got here as soon as I could. Probably a little too soon if you ask Wilson.
That's dark.
What about the rest of the people on the station?
This is the evac area. If they're not here now, they're not coming.
We can't leave without knowing for sure. We need to go back and look.
Don't you get it? The only one worth saving is you. Everyone else is expendable.
She's right. We all knew the risks when we signed up. Without you, there's no point to any of this.
All right, fair point.
Where are we going?
Another Cerberus facility. The elusive man is waiting for you there.
I'm not sure I trust you.
This is the only shuttle off the station. You want to stay and rot with the mechs? Be my guest.
I'd find some way off.
You're the Lazarus.
I'm Commander Shepard,
aren't you?
That's right. I put 2 years of my life into this project. Into you.
What does Cerberus want from me?
Maybe you should ask the elusive man when you meet him. He poured virtually unlimited resources into Lazarus. Obviously, he has some kind of plan for you.
I'm sure.
This station to last a lifetime.
Or two, in your case. Come on.
Alright, now we get to fill in the holes that you didn't see at the beginning. Poof. There we go.
Before you meet with the elusive man, we need to ask a few questions to evaluate your condition.
Come on, Miranda. More tests? Shepard took down those mechs without any trouble. That has to be good enough.
It's been 2 years since the attack. The elusive man needs to know that Shepard's personality and memories are intact. Ask the questions.
Did you say 2 years? I've been gone that long?
Yeah.
2 years and 12 days. And you were on an operating table for most of it.
The sooner we start, the sooner we can be done. Start with personal history.
Okay. Records show you were a spacer kid, raised mostly on one ship or another. You enlisted and won a medal fighting Batarians during the Skillian Blitz. Do you remember that?
A lot of lives depended on me holding that position. I did what I had to.
However you want to put it, it was damn impressive. I had friends who were there. Satisfied, Miranda?
Almost. Let's try something more recent.
Here we go.
Vermeier, where you destroyed Saren's cloning facility. You had to leave one of your squad behind to die in the blast.
Oh, not this one. It's the next one.
Caden Alenko was killed in action. It was your call. Why did you leave him behind?
I left a friend to die that day, and I didn't do it casually. But I had to save as many people as I could.
It's the cheeks.
He gave his life for the rest of the team. Without him, I couldn't have stopped Saren. He died a hero.
I understand, Commander. And I wasn't judging your decision. Everybody at Cerberus knows that cloning facility had to be destroyed.
Shepard, think back to the Citadel, after the Alliance saved the Destiny Ascension and you killed Saren. What happened next?
Yeah, they didn't save this part, so now you get to choose who is.
Humanity was offered a spot on the Council. I recommended Captain Anderson for the position.
Yes, Captain Anderson is now Counselor Anderson. Though from what I hear, he preferred life in the military.
Still, good to know that the human council member isn't going to put politics ahead of defense.
Your memory seems solid. There are other tests we really should run.
Come on, Miranda. Enough with the quizzes. The memories are there, and I can vouch for Shepard's combat skills personally.
I suppose you're right. We'll have to hope the elusive man accepts our little field test as evidence enough.
Oh, he fucking better. That's a big fucking station. There's a reason for it, though. Alright.
The elusive man is waiting for you in the other room.
Yeah. In due time. In due time. Fucking hell. Alright. I just want to show these off because they're pretty cool. Cerberus armor, Collector armor, Blood Dragon armor, Terminus armor, and Inferno armor. I will not be using any of these. For the simple reason, Mass Effect 3 does one thing better than Mass Effect 2, and that you can actually remove the fucking helmet in dialogue. So yeah.
God damn it.
But yeah, I'm gonna be using this stuff because I spent my damn money on it, I'm gonna use it. Just depends. Recharge your powers. What's this one do? Damn right. I'm going to be using this because honestly I think it looks a fuck ton cooler. Material. Perfect tint. There we go, pattern. There we go. I like you a lot. There we go. Shame you can't change the lights. And casual appearance. I always did like this look on both the male and female. Not a clue why. Eh, fuck it. Yeah, let's go with that. Alright. We're good. For now, at least. Yeah, that's the one thing about Mass Effect 3. During dialogue like this, the helmet would be removed. As long as you're not in a vacuum.
Commander Shepard.
Elusive man. I thought we'd be meeting face to face.
A necessary precaution. Not unusual for people who know what you and I know.
You might be the reason I'm still alive, but that doesn't mean I trust you.
You need to put your personal feelings aside. Humanity is up against the greatest threat of our brief existence.
The Reapers.
Good to see your memories still intact. How are you feeling?
You need to earn the right to ask me those kinds of questions.
Cerberus isn't as evil as you believe. You and I are on the same side. We just have different methods.
Did you?
Cut to the chase. What are the Reapers doing that made you decide to bring me back?
You killed an admiral.
We're at war. No one wants to admit it, but humanity is under attack. While you've been sleeping, entire colonies have been disappearing. Human colonies. We believe it's someone working for the Reapers, just as Saren and the Geth aided Sovereign. You've seen it yourself. You bested all of them. That's just one reason we chose you.
Fighting a war doesn't seem like Cerberus. Why are you involved?
We're committed to the advancement and preservation of humanity. If the Reapers are targeting us, trying to wipe us out, Cerberus will stop them. If we wait for politicians or the Alliance to act, no more human colonies will be left.
Do you know what? That is the one thing I like about some of what Mass Effect 2 does. It does put Cerberus in a grey area.
Sovereign was trying to harvest all life in the galaxy. Why would the Reapers target a few human colonies?
But then they take a right.
Hundreds of thousands of colonists have vanished. I'd say that fits the definition of harvesting. Nobody's paying attention because it's random. And the attacks occur in remote locations. I don't know why they've suddenly targeted humanity. Maybe you got their attention when you killed one of them.
Oh, you're damn right. Well, I didn't kill it. A bunch of fucking ships did. But, yeah, they paint them in a grey area here, but then they fucking take a right into Saturday Night cartoon villains in 3.
If this is a threat against humanity, you need to mobilize the Alliance.
They suffered substantial losses fighting Sovereign. They're rebuilding, still stretched too thin to waste resources verifying the Reaper threat. Blaming the abductions on mercs and pirates is easier and more convenient.
Why me?
You could have trained an entire army for what you spent to bring me back.
You're unique.
Yeah, damn right.
Ability or what you've experienced.
I'm player controlled.
What you represent. You stood for humanity at a key moment. You're more than a soldier. You're a symbol. And I don't know
just like Prince
understand fear, but you killed one. They have to respect that.
If what you say is true, if the Reapers are behind this, I'd consider helping you.
I'd be disappointed if you accepted any of this without seeing for yourself. I have a shuttle ready to take you to Freedom's Progress, the latest colony to be abducted. Miranda and Jacob will brief you.
Miranda killed Wilson in cold blood. Jacob's just a gun for hire. Expect me to trust them?
Wilson was one of my best agents, but he was a traitor. Miranda did exactly what I expected of her, and she saved your life in more ways than one. Jacob's a soldier, one of the best. He's never fully trusted me, but he's always been honest about it. You'll be just fine with them. For now.
That's a frat, asshole.
Is this a volunteer job, or am I being volunteered?
You always have a choice, Shepard. If you don't find the evidence we're both looking for, we can part ways. But first, go to Freedom's Progress. Find any clues you can. Who's abducting the colonies? Do they have any connection to the Reapers? I brought you back. It's up to you to do the rest.
And I do love that star behind him. That is one fucking cool star. Yay, level up. In fact, you know what? Wait till I get to Freedom's Progress, because then I can level up Miranda. And speaking of Miranda...
The elusive man is very impressed with you. I'm eager to see if you can live up to his expectations on this mission.
I never got a chance to say how much I appreciated what the Lazarus Project did for me.
I just hope it was worth it. A lot of people lost their lives on that station.
Ain't my fucking fault.
We have to work together here. Your attitude isn't helping anything.
I have the utmost respect for your abilities, Shepard. It's your motivations that concern me.
Uh-huh.
What Cerberus stands for. Only time will tell if you prove to be an asset or a liability to our cause.
Bitch, my motivations are solid.
Tell me a little about yourself.
Worried about my qualifications? I can crush a mech with my biotics or shoot its head off at 100 yards. Take your pick.
I was trying to get to know you as a human being.
I'm not looking for a friend, Shepard. Stay focused on the mission.
No.
Did you and Jacob serve together in the Alliance?
No. The elusive man recognized my potential and recruited me at a young age.
How old were you?
Old enough to know this is what I wanted.
Alright, fair enough. Alright, well, we're gonna learn more about our current mission anyway, so...
We've got an assignment. We can talk about it or we can do it.
You know, the one thing is, I can't remember. I don't think there is a place here I can change my fucking guns. Like, there's only the armor and... Which is slightly annoying because I don't think there is a place here I can change my weapons.
I'm glad the elusive man convinced you to join us, Commander.
I just want to find out what happened to those missing people. I still don't trust Cerberus.
Noted. Do you trust me, Commander?
You're a good man, Jacob. But you might be working for the wrong people.
Maybe.
No, but definitely.
When I was with the Alliance. That's why I'm here now.
You said you served in the Alliance.
5 years in total. Stationed all over the galaxy. Even spent a couple of years as a Corsair.
Yep, that's what my case is. As well as my water cooling.
I've never heard of the Corsairs.
It was an Alliance initiative. They hired independent starship captains and used them for missions that fell outside official Alliance jurisdiction.
Hmm.
Technically, we weren't part of the Alliance.
Mercs.
If we ever got caught, they could disavow any knowledge of us. We were supposed to be free from restrictions and rules. But there was still enough red tape to sink a cruiser. I finally just gave up.
Why did you join Cerberus?
I guess I just got tired of never making a difference. So much of what we did in the Alliance seemed pointless. I thought things would change after the attack on the Citadel. Humanity was finally invited to join the Council, but nothing changed. Politics, bureaucracy, same bullshit, different leaders. Cerberus is different. When colonies go missing, we don't commission a team to write a report to figure out what the hell to do about it.
Them eyebrows.
We just go and find out.
Alright, fuck it. Let's learn from him.
Do you know anything about this colony we're going to?
It's called Freedom's Progress. Don't know much else. I guess we'll find out when we get there.
And that's about all you'll fucking know.
Yes, ma'am.
Alright, let's get going. Mission summary. We leveled up. General shit. Here's our bonus. There we go. You've received the following bonuses for importing a level 60 character. 1 renegade. A single renegade point, and that is going to bug me. Import bonus. 10,000 for a bonus. Now, that means we have a fuck ton of credits. Long service bonus. Now, this is obviously because I've completed the game before. 20% experience. A fuck ton of credits again. Jesus Christ, I forgot. I completely forgot how many credits I fucking get. Jesus. That's a lot. Now, I didn't get a chance to actually look at the total number, so I'm going to pause and find out.
We should be there shortly, Shepard. The elusive man put us under your command. Do you have any orders?
What did you find at the other colonies?
Nothing. No signs of attack, no corpses, not even a trace of unusual genetic material to give us a clue. They just disappear. We've got no target to go after.
Well, shit.
Are you sure you'll be comfortable following my orders?
We didn't bring you back from the dead just to second guess you, Commander. If the elusive man says you're in charge, you're in charge.
What makes you think this investigation will turn up anything new?
At other colonies, official investigators got there first. Sometimes looters or salvage teams as well. We're hoping to be the first ones there this time. Maybe find clues before somebody else disturbs the scene.
Our first priority is to look for survivors.
That's unlikely, Commander. No one was left at the other colonies. They were completely deserted.
But you didn't have Shepard with you.
Somebody. Anything's better than another ghost town.
Next, I'm absolutely certain with Vanguard I have... Or... Wait, with Vanguard do I have a shotgun? Is it Vanguard I have a shotgun? I'm fucking hoping so, because a shotgun would actually help a lot. Those fucking goggles. And... nope, fuck. God. Yes! I have a shotgun! Okay. Shit just got easier. Yep, shit just got a hell of a lot easier. Thank fucking Christ we have a shotgun. Alright, now we need to upgrade Miranda. Let's get warp ammo two. Miranda, Cerberus. Boom. Let's get that. And warp. We'll get slam in the future. No, we don't have anything for you, Jacob. That's it. Oh yeah, speaking of which, hold up. Get rid of that.
Looks like everyone just got up and left, right?
Oh yeah, I forgot about that. Yep, everybody did just leave in a hurry. Place is a fucking ghost town.
Strange. No bodies, no structural damage, and no signs of battle.
I know, it's like they didn't have a chance to fight back. Like, everybody just poof, fucking disappeared. Which, the worst thing is, that's actually kind of what happened. Yeah, speaking of which, fucking hell, 338,000 with 60,000 of each material. That's cool. Hopefully that means I won't need to waste some time. Fuck me. Oh yeah, each of them have... yeah, they have armor, don't they? I forgot. Hardcore gives them. Hardcore gives them fucking armor. Shit.
Shoot them before they take out your shield.
Easier said than done, Miranda. Oh fuck no.
Target down.
No. Oh, this is what hardcore is gonna be like for me then, eh? Then again, I'm trying to save my shotgun ammo for a reason. His has started gloriously. Ah, oh, fuck. All right, fucking hell. Fucking hell, this ain't doing jack and shit. Ah, come on. Let's get the fucking shotgun out. There we go. Man, this thing's got no fucking range. Oh, will someone please just take that fucker out? No, you do not. Yeah, I wish there was an easier way to switch to weapons precisely, but there isn't.
They should have recognized us as human.
Someone reprogrammed them to attack on sight. We're not alone here.
Ah, so what is that I hear? Survivor? Oh. Guess it's a good thing you've got Commander Shepard with you, isn't it? Come on, get it open. There we go. 2,000 credits.
Spotted.
Well, no shit. There we go. That works. And here we are.
Stop right there.
Fraza, you said you'd let me handle this.
Hey, Tali!
Wait. Shepard?
I'm not taking any chances with Cerberus operatives.
Put those weapons down! Shepard? Is that... you're alive?
Remember when I gave you that Geth data, Tali? Did it help you complete your pilgrimage?
Yes, it did. Fraza, weapons down. This is definitely Commander Shepard.
Why is your old commander working for Cerberus?
I don't know. Maybe we should ask.
Damn right. Usual helps.
Cerberus spent 2 years rebuilding me. They want me to investigate attacks on human colonies.
Likely story. No organization would commit so many resources to bring back one soldier.
You haven't seen Shepard in action, Fraza. Trust me. It was money well spent.
Damn right. Thank you, Tali.
Perhaps we can work together. We're here looking for a young Quarian named Vitor. He was here on pilgrimage.
Isn't that a little strange? A Quarian visiting a remote human colony?
Quarians can choose where they go on pilgrimage. Vitor liked the idea of helping a small settlement. He was always nervous in crowds.
She means that he was unstable. Combine that with damage to his suit CO2 scrubbers and an infection from an open-air exposure, and he's likely delirious.
When he saw us landing, he hid in a warehouse on the far side of town. We suspect he also programmed the mechs to attack anything that moved.
Vitor's the only one who can tell us what happened here. We should work together to find him.
Good idea. You'll need two teams to get past the drones anyway.
Now we're working with Cerberus?
No, Fraza, you're working for me. If you can't follow orders, go wait on the ship.
Good one, Tala.
Warehouse through the center of the colony. We'll circle around the far side and draw off some of the drones to clear you a path.
Your people really don't like Cerberus. What did I miss?
They killed our people, infiltrated our flotilla, and tried to blow up one of our ships.
That's not how I'd have explained it exactly. It was nothing personal.
We can argue over who killed who later.
Just business.
Now we've got a job to do.
Agreed. We work together to get to Vitor.
Make sure to keep in radio contact.
Will do. Good luck, Shepard. Whatever happens, it's good to have you back.
See, at least someone's happy to see me. I'm genuinely happy. Like, usually people are shooting at me.
Be careful, Shepard. There's a squad of security drones up ahead.
Thanks for the warning. We'll take care of them.
Yeah, they're gonna be easy. Somewhat.
They've seen us.
Yeah, I think... I'm sure someone's going to be calling me out on this. But I live streamed this on Insanity. So, and the reason I want to have fun while I'm doing this. I don't want to be... try harding when it comes to completing this. So I might, for the next video, lower the difficulty back down to veteran. So that way, it's still challenging, but I'm not going to be wasting a lot of my time just trying really fucking hard for... Oh, wrong button. Trying really hard to finish it. Come on, Miranda. Wait, why isn't that in my... Go. Fucking hell, Jacob, you suck. Oh wow, Jacob's not dead. Miranda is though. Get up.
Shepard, Fraza and his squad rushed on ahead. I told them to wait, but they wouldn't listen.
No one does.
We have to find Vitor and take him away before you get here.
We should have expected this.
Come on. Still catch
By the way, in my stream I had a running joke about how useless Jacob is. So if I end up giving Jacob some unwarranted shit, that's why. Because he is just a walking joke for me. You fucking useless dick! He's fucking dead already. Will you die already? There we go.
They did want to get to Vito first.
Smart ass.
Yeah.
I'm gonna take my time. Yeah. I'm gonna take my sweet ass time doing this.
Take point, Shepard.
Oh yeah, we'll cover the door. I'm done being a dick.
Taking cover.
I'm done being a dick. Yeah, I switched the controls to where it's the directional keys here. Jesus, that's overkill! And that's two more down. That's a lot of dead quarians!
Those Quarians never stood a chance.
This is gonna be one tough son of a bitch to take down.
Yeah, no shit. By the way, Shepard, that's bullshit. You don't have an Avenger. Alright, first of all. Ow! Oi! Shit. Come on. Dick! Come on, get your fucking pistol up. Oh, I didn't want this. There we go. Ah, damn it. I really like taking the heads off of them so they explode in a nuclear explosion. Plus, I just love making a fool of it like that.
This is your chance to go find Vitor while I tend to the wounded, Shepard. He's probably somewhere in the back of the loading bay.
You need to tend to the fucking dead more than you are the wounded. Christ, nearly enough all of your team just got wiped out. God damn, how many Quarians died? Yes, okay, cool, we got weapon upgrade. Heavy weapon ammo upgrade, sorry. Speaking of which. Wall safe to bypass. The stick man giving a yay. A C, a battery, and two doors closing. Alright, let's go and get Vitor. I believe that's everything I could pick up. Yep.
Monsters coming back. Mechs will protect. Safe from swarms. Have to hide. No monsters. No swarms. No.
Vitor?
No, Vitor. Not here. Swarms can't find. Monsters coming. Have to hide.
Nobody's gonna hurt you anymore.
He long gone.
I don't think he can hear you, Commander.
Have to hide. human. Where did you hide? How come they didn't find you?
Who didn't find us?
The monsters. The swarms. They took everyone.
We weren't here.
We're not survivors, Vitor. We just got here.
Wow. No. Talk about sounding like a dick.
But I see everything.
Looks like security footage. He must have pieced it together manually.
What the hell is that?
My god. I think it's a collector.
Yeah, we're gonna need the explanation on that.
Is that some kind of alien?
They're a species from somewhere beyond the Omega 4 relay. Only a few people have ever seen one in person.
They usually work through intermediaries, like slavers or hired mercenaries. If they're involved with the Reapers somehow, it could explain what happened to the colonies.
The collectors have advanced technology. They could have a weapon that disables an entire settlement at once.
The Seeker swarms. No one can hide. The Seekers find you, freeze you, then the monsters take you away.
Ouch. So it's abduction. They were right.
Why didn't the collectors take you?
Swarms didn't find me. Monsters didn't know I was here.
The collectors aren't known for being careless. Maybe his enviro suit kept him from showing up on their sensors.
Or they were using technology specifically designed to detect humans. Only human colonies have been hit.
It makes sense.
Tell me more about these swarms.
It's how they find you. Seeker clouds, machines like tiny insects. They go everywhere. They find you, then they sting you, freeze you.
Sounds like miniature probes, maybe. Find victims, then immobilize them with a stasis field or nerve toxin.
I want to know more about the collectors.
Please.
Nobody knows much. They're so rare, a lot of people don't even believe they exist.
More importantly, why are they abducting human colonists? What are they after?
Maybe the elusive man can figure it out.
I'm sure that dick can.
What happened next?
The monsters took the people onto the ship, and then they left. The ship flew away. But they'll be back for me. No one escapes.
I think that's probably all we're getting out of him, Commander.
Cheers, Vito.
Appreciate what you told us. You were very helpful.
I studied them. The monsters. The swarms. I recorded them with my Omni tool. Lots of readings. Electromagnetic. Dark energy.
We need to get this data to the elusive man. Grab the Quarian and call the shuttle to come pick us up.
I think someone's going to object.
Vitor is injured. He needs treatment, not an interrogation.
We won't hurt him. We just need to see if he knows anything else. He'll be returned unharmed.
Your people tried to betray us once already. If we give him to you, we'll never get the intel we need.
Praza was an idiot, and he and his men paid for it. You're welcome to take Vitor's Omnitool data, but please, just let me take him.
You don't have to take Vitor and go. We could work together, just like old times.
I want to, but I can't. I've got a mission of my own. It's too important for me to abandon, even for you. When it's over, and I'm still alive, we'll see what happens.
That sounds dangerous. What are you doing?
I don't think Cerberus needs to hear about it. But it's in Geth space. That should tell you how important it is.
I prefer that dialogue over the alternative.
He's traumatized and he needs medical care. Tali will give us the Omnitool data and take him to the flotilla.
Understood, Commander.
Thank you, Shepard. I'm glad you're still the one giving the orders.
Damn right, I'm still the queen.
If I find anything that can help you, I'll let you know.
We're ready for pickup.
Yeah, get us the fuck out of here. Great. Another alien race. Clearly they've only shown up in the last 2 years, because we didn't hear about them in the last game.
Good work on Freedom's progress. The Quarians forwarded their findings from Vitor's debriefing. No new data. But it's a surprising olive branch, given our history. You and I have different methods, but I can't argue with your results.
You ever think about playing nice once in a while?
Diplomacy is great when it works, but difficult when everyone already perceives you as a threat.
And that's
but
true.
More importantly, you confirm the collectors are behind the abductions.
Why do I get the feeling you knew about them already?
I had my suspicions, but I needed proof. The collectors are enigmatic at best. They periodically travel to the terminus systems, looking to gather seemingly unimportant items or specimens, usually in exchange for their technology. When their transactions are complete, they disappear as quickly as they arrived, back beyond the unmapped Omega 4 relay. Until now, we've had no evidence of direct aggression by the Collectors.
Yeah, I wonder why.
Why is the Omega 4 relay unmapped? What do we know about it?
Only that no ship passing through it has ever returned. Our best guess is that the relay reacts differently to Collector vessels, allowing them safe passage. If they can manipulate relays, that's just further evidence of the connection with the Reapers.
Oh no, they don't manipulate relays. The whole fucking reason on why is even more fucking ridiculous.
Any ideas on why they've shifted their focus to humans?
If they're agents for the Reapers, it could be any number of reasons. Obviously, humanity played a huge role in Sovereign's destruction. That might have been enough to draw their attention. What really concerns me is why they bother abducting the colonists. Once the humans are paralyzed, why not just kill them?
What are the Collectors getting from these deals?
The Collectors aren't very forthcoming about their motives.
So no one fucking knows.
They seek out species with rare genetic mutations or abnormalities. They pay slavers and merc groups exorbitant sums to obtain these specimens, and then they leave. But they've never targeted a single species before, and the previous sample sizes were in the dozens, not the tens of thousands.
You're holding something back. How do you know the Reapers are involved?
The patterns are there, buried in the data.
That's not an answer.
The Alliance want to believe the Reaper threat died with Sovereign. You and I know better. I won't wait until the Reapers are on the march. We need to take the fight to them.
If this is a war, I'll need an army, or a really good team.
I've already compiled a list of soldiers, scientists, and mercenaries. You'll get dossiers on the best of them. Finding them and convincing them to work with you could be challenging, but you're a natural leader. I'll continue to track the Collectors. When they make their next appearance, I'll notify you and your team. Be ready.
Keep your list. I want people I trust. The ones who helped me stop Saren and the Geth.
That was 2 years ago, Commander.
Yeah.
Both of them have moved on, or their allegiances have changed.
All right, let's find out where they all are then.
Where's Ashley Williams?
She's still with the Alliance. Promoted, I believe. Her file is surprisingly well classified.
Where's Erdnot Rex?
He returned to Chichanka, and he hasn't gone off-world in over a year. He's trying to unite the Krogan clans.
Noble goal.
What about Tally? She already helped us.
Yeah, she took our advice.
That was unexpected. I need more intel before I'll commit to that.
Where's Garrus Vakarian?
The Turian.
Off playing Batman.
You were declared dead. Even we haven't been able to locate him.
Again, he's off playing Batman. And that's no joke, he really fucking has.
Where's Liara Tassoni?
She's on Ilium. My sources say that she's working for the Shadow Broker. If so, she can't be trusted.
I would beg to differ, but I have a conflict of interest in that department.
Okay, I get it. They're not available.
You're a leader, Shepard. You'll get who you need.
I'm still a Spectre. Maybe I can get the Council to help us out.
If you think you can convince them, by all means. Just remember, you've been gone a long time. Things have changed.
You worry about the Collectors. I'll make sure my team's ready.
Good. Two things before you go. First, head to Omega and find Morden Solus. He's a brilliant Solarian scientist. Our intelligence suggests he may know how to counteract the Collector's paralyzing seeker swarms.
I haven't even started and you're telling me what to do?
I'm giving you direction. What you do with it is up to you. I'm sure you'll make the right decision.
All right. What's the other thing?
I've found a pilot I think you might like. I hear he's one of the best. Someone you can trust.
Oh, self-proclaimed best.
Hey, Commander. Just like old times, huh?
Hey, Joker.
I can't believe it's you, Joker.
Look who's talking. I saw you get spaced.
Got lucky. With a lot of strings attached. How'd you get here?
It all fell apart without you, Commander. Everything you stirred up, the Council just wanted it gone. The team was broken up, record sealed, and I was grounded. The Alliance took away the one thing that mattered to me. Hell yeah, I joined Cerberus.
You really trust the elusive man?
Well, I don't trust anyone who makes more than I do. But they aren't all bad. Saved your life, let me fly, and there's this. They only told me last night.
Yes! I fucking love this reveal. Like, if I remember correctly, this fucker's twice as big as the original Normandy as well. Oh, it's so good to see it. Ah. It really does feel good to be playing this game again.
It's good to be home, huh, Commander?
I guess we'll have to give her a name.
Like you need to ask. It's obviously going to be the Normandy. There we go. The Normandy SR2. Damn right. Alright, mission summary. Pretty much everything we already know. Like, the mission summaries don't tell us really anything that we don't already know, so. But yeah, for the next video, I will be lowering the difficulty to veteran. Thought it would be a good idea to try on hardcore, but evidently I died in the first fucking mission. Well, second, technically. I make this suit look good.
Welcome aboard the new Normandy, Commander.
I've been looking over the dossiers. I'd strongly recommend starting by acquiring Morden Solus, the Solarian professor on Omega.
Nope.
We know the Collectors use some type of advanced technology to immobilize their victims. We'll need him to develop a countermeasure to protect us.
And without that countermeasure, we'll be helpless if we ever run into the Collectors.
Acquiring Professor Solus seems like the most logical place to start.
Who are you?
I am the Normandy's artificial intelligence. The crew like to refer to me as Edie.
Oh, shit.
Helmsmen aren't happy when someone takes control of a ship away from them. Especially Joker.
Here we go.
The ship. Mr. Moreau's talents will not go to waste. During combat, I operate the electronic warfare and cyber warfare suites. Beyond that, I cannot interface with the ship's systems. I observe and offer analysis and advice. Nothing more.
I'm guessing it takes more than just the three of us plus Joker to fly this ship.
Damn right.
The Navy has a full crew. They're at their stations awaiting your orders.
Final preparations for takeoff are complete, Commander. When you're ready to go, just pick a destination from the galaxy map and the CIC and I'll plot a course.
Jacob and I should return to our posts. Come find us if you have any questions.
I'll try. Later, Jacob. Alright, galaxy map. Use the galaxy map to pick new destinations in the Normandy. Obviously, emails. Oh yeah, and outfits for crew members, which I will be using people's alternate attires because some of them look badass. And our weapons, which we're immediately going to take a beeline for. And that's just got to different decks. And our upgrades, basically. Problem is we need Solus to do that. Shit, I do want to get some upgrades. Alright, but the problem is we're going to have to end it for this part. Oh, I can't wait to continue with this. So, thanks for watching, everybody. I'm Dante Crisis. Signing off, and I'll see you next time.